Hi, welcome to Morphite Update number 2. This is our second time that we're updating you on all the goings on here at Morphite, what we're working on, all of that kind of stuff. So we're going to kind of go through some of the things we've done, some of the things we're working on, and give you some updates so you know both what we've accomplished and what you can expect over the upcoming months. So one of the first things we wanted to talk about is our new studio upgrades that we're working on here. You can tell we've got a background going on. We've still got a lot in the works with that. We've got our microphones. Actually got some lapel mics set up, so hopefully the audio, if you're hearing us right now, is going to be a lot cleaner, a lot better. We've got a little bit better lighting. A lot of that stuff's in progress, but if you watched our previous video, which you'll be able to check out on our channel, you can see that this video is already a big step up from that. We need to introduce ourselves. I'm Sam.
I'm Dan.
And I'm Mark.
All right. So if you haven't seen our previous video, if you just found this for some reason, that's who we are. And we are Morphite. We are a company that's dedicated to innovating and inventing. And so there's a lot of stuff that we'll be doing, and you'll be able to catch up on this channel. Before we get into anything else, I do want to plug our website. It's morphite.net. That's morphite.net. And you can see on there both updates on what we're doing. We've got a blog going. We'll have links to all of the social media stuff. So please go check that out. Put it on your bookmarks, whatever you want to do, so you can catch up with us between these kind of video updates. These update videos are going to come out once a month, so we'll catch you up on everything we've done during the month and everything we're looking at towards the next month, so you can keep track of that. So one of the things we want to talk about is all the stuff we've gotten done so far. It's now, we're into February, it is 2020. We have, since the beginning, since we started in January, we've already got our social media stuff set up. Anybody who's done that knows there's a lot of work involved there. We've got a logo that we landed on. We've got our website live, and we started actually getting followers on some of our social media stuff already, so that's really cool. You may have noticed, if you checked out our channel, that we have both our update video and we have a cartoon commentary video that we already did. Mark and I actually worked on that on the commentary video, and we've got a couple more coming out as well. The commentary video was an interesting endeavor because we thought we were just going to go watch some cartoons, right? And just have fun and kind of share that with you
guys.
That
was the hope, yeah.
Yeah, but come to find out, with YouTube, anybody who's done YouTube at all knows fair use does not mean that it will be easy use. So as we were jumping through all those hoops trying to get things working, we decided to stick with just public domain videos for now on the cartoons. So if you guys are catching up with that, that's why we have certain things we're going to be doing. Another thing I want to plug, though, jumping off of that, is our Subscribestar. Our Subscribestar page is now set up. We'll have a link in the description of this video. And if you go there, we just have one tier for now, but we'll be adding more tiers. And on there, you'll be able to access stuff that we may have recorded but didn't have a chance to fit it into one of our regular series here on YouTube, or things that, for one reason or another, we're not able to do on YouTube or BitChute or another platform. So please check that out. If you can, skip your latte for the month or whatever, send us $3. We would love to be able to, we would love to get some support so we can actually pay for all the stuff we're doing, hosting all those things. And we're actually, our goal right now, as of this month, is to get to 50 subscribers at the $3 level so we can at least cover our operating expenses for the things we're working on. As far as the website goes, as I mentioned earlier, we've got our blog posts that are going up. We've got multiple podcasts. You want to maybe go through some of the podcast stuff, some of the series that we're talking about?
Well, first and foremost, we have Morphite Chat coming up. We have a bunch of people that we want to talk to. Knowledgeable people. We're trying to make it somewhat entertaining as well as informative. We're going to start talking to people and interviewing people, other entrepreneurs, etc., and putting those out under the name of Morphite Chat, the title of Morphite Chat. That's going to be that series of podcasts. We also have, we may have a celebrity guest or two come in and help us with local celebrity, help us with some of the commentary stuff on cartoons. We've talked about it. We have a few people in mind. Another one that we've talked about doing, which is going to be for subscribers only, Sam and I are going to talk, and Dan will probably pop in from time to time, but it's going to be us talking, giving it a more in-depth, from the ground up view of what's going on right now in reference to entrepreneurship, our personal experiences with that. I know this is technically my second company I'm starting, and Sam has helped start other ones before. We have a little bit of varying experience on that, but anything in relation to that. And then also it's going to be kind of a catch-all as well. We'll be discussing just anything. It'll be little small episodes of just open format discussion. So we'll probably get into some conspiracy theory stuff and aliens and all that.
All that good stuff. Yeah. So that's kind of some of the stuff we have in the works already. Some of these things have already been recorded. Some of them are going to be recording here soon. So keep an eye out for that stuff. We're going to be releasing different things, whether it's videos or podcast format. So, you know, whatever you want to catch us on, we'll have those coming out. As far as our products go, we've got a couple big things planned for this year. One of them we mentioned in a little bit more at length in the last update, which is that Sonovox. And you want to fill us in maybe on where we're at with that, Mark, and some of the things that we've been working on?
Sure, sure. Currently, the biggest update on that is that I just bought some filament for the 3D printer, which is, and you can't really see it here, but I'll be making another video to illustrate. This is actually glow-in-the-dark 3D filament, and it's glow-in-the-dark blue. We have we've revamped our logo. Sam redid it since the last time, and actually we've got more ideas for that. But one thing I want to do is in our 3D printing is to bring out the logo with, since it's blue, glow-in-the-dark blue. Anyway, that's basically where we're at now. I'm making the video describing with the Sonovox and exactly showing the details of where it's at, exactly how it's made, everything about it, really.
Cool. That'll be great. Yeah, and I know I've had some people ask me already, you know, what is the Sonovox? How does it work? A lot of that stuff with it, it's like you kind of have to see it in action to be able, it's hard to describe, it really is. And you kind of have to see how it works to be able to see that. So we're hoping we'll be able to fill you in on that. As far as future plans for this year with that, we're looking at tentatively the middle of the year, we're going to end up doing a Kickstarter with the product. We're going to have it pretty developed at that point as far as it being a complete thing that we can then go to Kickstarter to get the actual funding to go into a production of it. So if you're interested in that, please subscribe to our channel. Again, follow us on the website, and we'll be sending out updates on those things as they come out. The other big project we're looking at for the end of the year probably is going to be a book that we're working on. And I think we talked about it in the last update of The Concrete Jungle. It's a whole universe kind of that that's being developed, but that will be the first volume of episodes, adventures in that world. So keep an eye out for that as well. That'll probably be coming down the pipe towards the end of the year. On just the kind of admin and business side of things, we got our official business registration going. Yeah. Which was kind of it's one of those first steps where it's just kind of like, you know, just paperwork. We got our websites live, you know, we got all that stuff registered and taken care of and hooked up, you know, and we even have an official email, you know, all that kind of stuff. So all that's happened over the past month. As far as the other things, I don't know if we mentioned it a lot in the last episode, but we were going over the things to talk about. And one of the big things is that we're all here now. We can actually all work on things. We actually get going. That's a big thing that we accomplished, in January.
Yeah, it seems simple, but
yeah. And we've got some equipment updates we've done. We got a couple cameras. They're nothing fancy, if you can tell, but it is what we need right now to get done what we want to get done. That's another reason why with the Subscribestar stuff, we ask you to actually consider, you know, donating for that so that we can be able to upgrade our equipment and get things going and just provide better content as we go. Yeah, and a lot of that stuff, it was, if you can tell the difference between last video and this video, we just wanted to get going, and that's one of the biggest things that's hard to do, is to make sure everything's moving and just make stuff happen. It'll be messy, it won't be perfect, but we wanted to just go ahead and get going on that stuff.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, there are going to be a lot of changes, but hopefully, on the positive side of that, you all will be able to see throughout the videos the progress that we make.
Mm-hmm. That's kind of stuff we've got done. The other things we're working on, you'll notice we had our first cartoon commentary come out. Then we're going to be having those come out regularly. So our goal right now, starting this month in February, is we're going to have at least one video coming out every week. So we have something going on every week. We'll have blog posts coming out on the regular. And then some of those videos will also be podcasts as well. So we'll release those in just audio-only format. The things we're working on right now, is the Sonovox is just an ongoing development. The book, of course, writing is not an overnight process. It takes a long time. So that's something we started on this month. And then the other thing that we're going to start working on here really, really soon this month is starting to do some tests and some planning, some preparation for the rotoscoping process. Dan, do you want to do just a brief overview of what rotoscoping is?
Rotoscoping has been around for a long time, since the Fleischer era of animation. I believe the Fleischer Studios invented it or began doing that.
Process, yeah.
And it was originally a process of tracing images from films, and you would stand at a device that they had designed for this, and you would put paper or whatever over a projection and trace image by image, frame by frame, from a film that had been taken. And so this allows you to animate based on the movement that is captured from a live-action subject. And there are many advantages to that. Sometimes it's used to make animation faster and cheaper. But for our purposes, we want to explore what all can be done with rotoscoping, how it can be beneficial in bringing to life the performances of the actors involved. And that is something that we feel is important, is bringing a human element to animation, to any production that we make. We want that to be captured. We want that to come through the animation.
Yeah, and you may be familiar with this process a little bit with the motion capture process that they use for everything from Marvel to, all kinds of stuff now. One of the biggest performances people saw this for the first time was Gollum in the first Lord of the Rings movie, or second one, I guess, is this motion capture process. And so essentially, because we decided to commit to a two-dimensional, 2D, hand-drawn animation style, this is basically motion capture, but in two dimensions, if it helps to wrap your mind around that. And like I said, we'll be testing that over the next couple weeks, and so we may have some things we'll put up here and there showing that process.
I was going to add that a notable earlier example of rotoscoping would be like the old Superman cartoons.
Oh, yeah.
If you've ever seen those, that's a very prominent example in pop culture, I guess, of that.
Yeah.
And what, I don't know, was Snow White or one of those like that as well?
They used it in a limited way in a lot of the early animation because...
I feel like Disney did it a bit.
Yeah, Disney did do a lot of it. They used a lot of reference footage, and then there are specific scenes that are drawn over that are rotoscoped directly.
There are some animation directors known for often using rotoscope, such as Ralph Bakshi.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Don Bluth has used it. Anastasia is a great example of it being done well in many of the characters.
Yeah, I mean, there's a litany of examples for that. But like he said, one of the reasons we decided that we wanted to go into that is there's a couple different things. For one thing, it actually is kind of a shortcut. A lot of people treat it as lesser because of that, because they feel like, well, you're just tracing. But there is a lot of artistry involved as far as the design and then, of course, the whole filmmaking process, because essentially you're filming your actors, you're filming your scene, and then you're taking that, and instead of going in and doing post-production with color grading and all those things, you're going in and editing and making a cut version and then animating on top of that. So in essence, it's not really a shortcut. And then we're not going to be using a completely automated process like you may see with, what do they call it? Is it Rotomation? Where it essentially comes out looking I've seen people refer to it as like an Instagram filter effect. We're not going to be going for that because we do want to have a unique look to the characters and to the animation. But it will be, it does shorten your production a lot where you don't have to have, and more cheaply, we don't have to hire Disney, to make our film. We can make it ourselves because we can shoot and then animate on top of it. Again, a lot of this will make more sense when you can actually see things that we create. So it's a lot cheaper in some ways, and it cuts down some production on different levels. The other thing, like Dan mentioned, though, is your characters. You can immediately translate the reactions, the facial animations, that kind of stuff from your character actors, and get a closer look at what they put into a performance instead of being several stages removed. I was just watching recently where they explained a video explaining how they animated Thanos for the Marvel films. And they were talking about how they have the motion capture process, they do the facial capture, all of that, and then essentially redo all of it in the animation. They use it as a reference point, but it's what you see on the screen is not a direct just taking that data and then just putting a model on it and then it animating the character. There's a lot of hands-on throughout that whole process. There's a removal, there's a distance between the actor performance and the end result. Now, depending on the artistry of everyone involved in that gap, it can look really good, like Thanos turned out on those films. But what we want to try to do with the rotoscoping as part of that is to try to lessen that gap as much as we can so that we're getting animation so we can do some crazy cool stuff, some great stories, some fantastic things, but we're also capturing as close to an actor's performance as you can, even though it's animated. And then the third thing that adds, though, is proportionality. If you, next time you watch an animated film, here's some homework for you, go watch anything, any animated movie, and count how many of the shots have a moving camera in them. If you were watching this animation and there was actually a camera on set, how many times it's a camera that's set in one place, and how many times it's a camera that's a view that's actually moving, rotating around, that kind of thing. And you'll notice that most of the time it's a static camera. Of course, for TV shows and that kind of stuff, it's a lot cheaper and faster to just do static camera shots anyways. But what rotoscoping allows you to is have a moving camera and still retain proportionality of both the actors, whatever it is, whatever you're videoing in frame, as well as things that are in the background and proportions of your perspective and all that kind of stuff. I'm trying to think of a good example of that, of rotoscoping to kind of highlight. We might see if we can find one and throw it in the links in the description to give you a good example of a film that uses the rotoscoping for those kind of things, for showing the moving shots and all of that. But that gives you a lot more activity and a lot more life to the shot versus just a painted flat background and characters kind of moving on in a stage. So that's another reason why we wanted to go with that. I feel like I've been talking about rotoscoping for a long time now. But a lot of this is stuff we've discussed at length off camera, you know, all the time. It's part of the reason we're fascinated with animation, with that whole process. If you check out our previous video, the cartoon commentary, the first one we did with Popeye, there's a similar thing to that, where they use that tabletop mechanism to be able to get a moving, rotating background that looks very lifelike, because it is lifelike. They created a model and rotated it around. If you want to check that out, you can see our cartoon commentary video on that Popeye versus Sinbad. As far as other things we're working on, we got the rotoscoping going on. We got some music stuff in the works, so we may not have anything to release on that anytime soon, but we are working on it. So you want to keep up to see that stuff. Again, we've got upgrades we're working on in the meantime, and hopefully soon here we'll have our podcast actually syndicated and distributed so that you can get on your favorite podcast player and hook it up on that. Well, that's our Morphite update number 2. As I mentioned earlier, please look us up, morphite.net, morphite.net. You can also from there, or just go to subscribestar.com/morphite, and you can get on there if you want to toss us $3 a month, and that way we can continue doing what we're doing. And otherwise, we'll see you in the next one.